Hi, in this segment, we'll talk about how to access AWS using Linux or Mac using through SSH and how to transfer files as well. All right, so let's go to the screen. I'm going to aws.amazon.com, and I'm assuming you've already set up the instance like we talked about in a previous segment. I'll sign in here and go to EC2, the top left of our screen. And that will pull up our instance. Okay, so on the left we choose instances. And this instance is selected. I'm going to minimize the screen for a second. Now we press connect. All right, so this gives us some really plain instructions for how to connect through SSH. Okay, so first I'm going to go to the folder that has my key pair in it, which is my documents folder. All right, and now the first, or I guess step number three, it says to do the chmod 400. This is to make sure it's a private key and not public. Or that it's not publicly viewable. So we type that in, just as it has written. And nothing shows up, which means it worked. All right, and so now the next step is to type in the command that it shows under example. We'll just make one small change, ssh-idealtokeypair.pem. But our username is ec2-user, not root. So that will be the same for all of you. And then I'll type in the IP address. Okay, press enter. And now we're logged in. So pretty straightforward on how to connect to AWS through SSH. Okay, you can see all of our files are there. We still have example. Oops, CD example. And we have main.cc in there. I'm going to delete that. And then we'll transfer that over again using SCP. Okay, so now we're all set up through SSH, but we do need to be able to transfer files back and forth, right? So I'll click down here on connection documentation and it'll pull up another page. I'm click on Linux using SSH and scroll down to transferring files. Okay, so first you need to have an SCP client, which you probably already have. Okay, so I'm going to open up another terminal and we'll use these directions. Okay, this step one is optional. So we'll go to step two. Step two says to change directories to go to where your key pair is located. So we could do that. I'm going to do it another way. I'm just going to stay in my current folder and then just specify the file to my key pair. It's just another way to do it. So we type in scp-i. And since I'm in Linux, since I'm using Linux, I can use this /... to specify my home directory. Documents, and then deal2keypair.pem. Okay, so that specifies the location of my key pair. Next, we specify the location of the file that we want to copy. So first, I'm going to copy the file from my computer to AWS. So that's in desktop/example/main.cc. Okay, now I need to specify where I want it to copy to. And so that will be on AWS. So I use my username ec2-user@. Now I need my public DNS, so I can close this out and scroll over so I can see public DNS. I can copy this address. Okay, Control-C, Control-Shift-V, and then colon, and I'll specify the file path on AWS. So again, I can do tilde to specify the home directory, and I want to put it in example. Press enter. And there it's copied over. We can look at our SSH terminal, and you can see, again, we have main.cc on our AWS instance. All right, so now let's copy that back, just to show you how to copy. For example, if you've run your code on AWS, you have some .vtk files you want to visualize, so this is how you would copy them back to your own machine to visualize them. Okay, so we'll still do the same scp-i and give the location of the key pair, documents deal to key pair.pem. Again, that's the name I'm using, whatever key pair, whatever name you've given your key pair. Of course, you'll put that in there. Now I want to copy a file from AWS, so I'll type in, I'm essentially just switching the order from the previous command. So EC2 user at my public DNS. The file is in example main.cc, and I want to copy it to my example folder on my desktop. And just to distinguish between two files, I'll call that main2.cc. And enter, and it's copied over. We can open up that file, and you can see there it is, main2.cc. All right, so now you are able to copy your files back and forth on Linux, or be the same on a Mac, and also run your code on AWS. So now we have a couple different ways to run DL2, either through AWS on Mac and Linux using SSH, or on Windows using PuTTY or MindTerm, or we could use the virtual machine on Linux, Mac, or Windows. All right, so you should be all set up now to run the example code or to run your own homework files using DL2.